Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video. I am so excited to be sharing with you guys a review of the Haakaa Ladybug Silicone Milk Collectors. These things are absolutely amazing and a game changer for catching your letdown in milk and being able to get that nice little stash going. They are fantastic. They come in two different sizes, a 2.5 ounce, which is the ones that I have, as well as a 5 ounce size. So depending on your output, your supply level, and how much you leak, you can kind of know whether to get the 2.5 or the 5 ounce side, but they are absolutely amazing. And so with no further ado, let's jump into the video. Before I tell you guys all my favorite little things about these two little guys, I do want to let you know that this video is sponsored by Haakaa themselves, but my thoughts and opinions are just that, they are my own. I have been using these for a while, so I will tell you my experience and what I love and don't love about them. And so here we go. My absolute favorite all-time favorite thing about the ladybugs is the fact that they are basically spill-proof. Like, there's only two holes, the one back here for your nipple to actually go in, and then this little spout up at the top. So you just pull the little tab out. I hope that is showing up on camera. Just pull that out and you can see the little hole there, and that is actually how you pour it into your bottle or milk bag. You can transfer it that way, but it has this nice little stopper here that you can see. And so that is absolutely amazing, because I can't tell you how many times with my first daughter I used a couple of other different like milk collector type things, because you don't want all of that precious liquid gold that either going into a breast pad that is either going to go in the garbage or get washed. And then if you have the reusable kind, yeah, we want to save every ounce of that you can. But needless to say, I wish I would have had these a long time ago, but I'm so glad I have them now. But yeah, that is my favorite thing, is the fact that they do not spill. Another thing I love about the ladybug is the mild suction, and that is something that I wanted. I didn't want to cause oversupply, because that leads to engorgement, which leads to mastitis, which is not fun. If you've experienced it, you know. If you haven't, try to avoid it at all costs, because that is like the worst and most uncomfortable thing ever. But all you have to do to use a little bit of suction with these is just press in on the front side of the milk collector, then stick your nipple inside of the hole and then release the suction, and you have a little bit of suction going there. So if you do want it to like slightly pull just a little bit and kind of make it a little more, then you can totally use that. Or if you just want to pop it in your bra regularly, then you can do it without suction. I have used it both ways and I get quite a bit of letdown either way whenever I am leaking, and so that works perfectly for that. If you do like to use the suction though, I will say just be careful not to, when you insert your nipple, to put it too far in, that when the suction does, it like sucks your nipple against the front wall, because then you won't catch quite as much. It like almost stops it from coming out, and so you definitely don't want to do that. So just kind of keep that in mind when you're placing it on. Another great thing about these little guys is that you can actually sleep in them. So that's pretty cool. So if you want to really be catching that letdown, then you can do so. Just don't forget to empty them within the recommended timeline of being able to safely collect that milk if you're wanting to feed it to your baby. It's recommended that you have your milk into the refrigerator within 4 hours of it being expelled from your body. So as soon as you can do that, then go ahead and get it in the refrigerator. But as far as being able to wear these, they are on great within your bra and they are not like spilling or coming out. If you're like me and you like to lie down and nurse, or if you need to do the reclined position, if you have a little bit heavier of a flow and you're needing to kind of lay back a little bit to give the baby a little bit of a break with your speed of your letdown, then that works great for that too, because it's not going to be like sloshing out or spilling on you. Once you're finished nursing, if you need to lay baby down in the bassinet or the crib and you kind of bend just a little bit, you're okay. You're not spilling anything out. You're not losing those precious drops of liquid gold that you collected. So that is another amazing prop for this thing as well. The next thing I want to talk about are the little feet on the bottom. Oh my goodness, this is amazing and such a game changer from so many other milk collectors that are on the market, is because we have used those and have went round and round over the fact that I either got upset and spilt milk, or my husband spilt the milk because I had asked him to do something with the milk collector and yeah, it just is not fun. And especially when you're sleep deprived, yeah, spilt milk is a sore subject. But having the little feet so you can set them on your nightstand or your end table beside of your couch, wherever you are lounging with baby, it helps so, so much, and you don't have to worry about it going anywhere. I've seen some people ask if you can use this without a bra, and it's definitely not recommended. I personally wouldn't recommend it. I used it that way once just to be like, let's see, I wonder if I could. Yeah, let's not do that. The first time your baby wiggles, it is just off and there's spilt milk and there you go. It's one more thing to clean. It's another laundry problem. But yeah, highly recommend using this with your bra. It is so discreet and easy and comfortable and just so much better with a bra. So highly recommend using the bra. And I know them being discreet is a question that a lot of people have. So I'm just going to pop this in so you can like see a side angle of like what it's like on and off. And yeah, hold on one second. Okay, so as you may or may not can tell, I don't know, it's hard to say on camera. I have the one on the right side, but I don't have one on the left side. So yeah, you can tell I have something in there if you're looking at me and I don't have both of them in at the same time, obviously. Now, if I have both of them in, you just think, oh, she just has large boobs. Like, it's really so discreet and smooth under your bra that you can't even tell when you have those in. I have actually worn these around people and like, people weren't like, what's up with your boobs? Like, I didn't get looks or anything weird. It was just like, you just have boobs, like that it's what it is. But yeah, if you turn to the side, you can definitely tell it sticks out a little bit farther, but not bad. So completely discreet to me in that way. But let me pop the other one in so you can kind of see what that looks like. All right, so this is what it looks like when I have both of them in. It just, to me, I can't tell the difference. And they look exactly the same. Now, me personally, looking down, the last time I nursed right before filming this video, my daughter ate out of my right side, but didn't from my left. So you know how that gets a little uneven. So personally, looking down, the left side does stick out just ever so slightly farther because all I did was catch my letdown on that side. So there is still milk in there. But other than that, they're even. When I wear these and she nurses from both sides and we are even, then we're even. But anyway, breasts are sisters and not twins. So I know that's probably a lot of rambling, but I just want to be like honest with my thoughts and opinions about these. And so yeah, very discreet, very comfortable. Like honestly, I will wear these and I get so busy like doing other things or taking care of the girls, and I literally forget they're on and like they're just so comfortable. And it's great because it's catching all of that letdown that you have throughout the day. And yeah, two thumbs up for these. And I know you're probably like, oh, you just gave this glowing review. What's wrong with them? Honestly, nothing. Except for the fact that I really wish that they had markers on them for measurements. It's not a deal breaker, obviously, because all of the other benefits outweigh the fact that they don't have ounce markers on them or milliliter marks on them. But I really wish they would have that, because if you're not pouring them directly into a bottle, then you won't know how many ounces or whatever that you caught. And so before you're able to put those in a bag, you kind of have to like put it in a bottle and then into the bag, because every bag is different. And unless you like open it the same and properly each time, then your measurements and what you write on the bag can be wrong. And so you're thinking, oh, I'm pulling out 2 ounces of milk, but it's really like one. So I hope that makes sense. If you've dealt with milk and you froze it in milk bags, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But yeah, that would be amazing if they could just like somehow on the side or the front just like have little markers. I think that would be amazing for storing and knowing what you need, especially as like baby gets bigger and you're sending them to daycare, or if you're having someone else to watch them, or if they're just staying home with your spouse while you run out and run some errands or go shopping or go to the spa for the day, whatever. That way that they can know like what to pull and when they're like needing to defrost milk. Yeah, that's a lot of rambling to explain as to why I wish they had marks, but I hope that made sense. But yeah, that is my biggest con, that everything else, no leaking, being able to be discreet in your bra, being comfortable, not being so like so much suction that it causes oversupply. All of those things are absolutely amazing about this, and I cannot recommend these enough. So I will actually have a link for you guys to check them out down in the description box below, so you can go on down and do a little shopping if you need to. But that's gonna do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then please hit the thumbs up button down below, as well as if you are new here and you like all things motherhood with a little bit of Disney magic sprinkled in along the way, then go ahead and hit the red subscribe button. We would love to have you around. And thank you so much again to Haakaa for sponsoring today's video. They're an amazing company with amazing products, so definitely head down to the description box and check those out. But I will see you guys right back here in a brand new video. Bye, you guys. Thanks again. Oh,